Hey everyone, so in this video we'll be taking a look at this safety gate that's manufactured by Fisher-Price. And as a part of this video, first we'll take a look at the installation part, and then towards the end I'll do a little demo where you can see how this product works. Now before that, here's a gate that I had installed around 8 months back. Now this one is installed at the entrance of my kitchen and it's manufactured by SafoKid. So feature wise it's more or less same like the Fisher-Price one, and over here if you see the entrance is a bit wide, so I had to install two extensions, one on the left and one on the right. So basically with these gates you can create child friendly areas within your home, and it'll be really convenient to keep an eye on your kids. So let's quickly get to the installation part. Alright, so I've taken the product out of the box and this is what you get in it. So this right here is the instruction manual, which also has the list of items that are included in the package. So what you get is this safety gate, and then you have a key and four bolts, which I believe are packed in this box right here in the brown box. And if you notice, there are some instructions about not cutting this belt. Which is basically a cable tie that's attached here. So before the installation is done, do not cut this out. This needs to be cut only after the product is completely installed. And it's also mentioned that the door gap is not a defect. So after installation, the gap will be shortened. So they are talking about this particular part, and you may think that this is actually a defect, but it's not. And once you install this product with the pressure bolts, this thing will get compressed and the locking mechanism will start working. So we'll get to that once we start installing it. So before we do that, we need to measure the distance between the door or the place where you want to install it. So this gate by itself can fit between doorways that are 33 to 37 inches wide. And you can use a measuring tape to measure the distance between your doorway or the passage where you want to install it. And then if the passage is bigger than the limit that's supported by the gate, you can order extensions which can be purchased separately. So you get different sizes for the extensions and you can order one depending on your need. All right, so now let's take the bolt and the key out. So remember not to cut this particular safety tie or the cable tie that's installed here. So this needs to be taken off only once the product is completely installed. So these are the four bolts that you get in the package, and a key that can be used at the end to tighten up these bolts. So basically it's a tool-free installation. You don't need any special tools to install this product. And I forgot to mention that this was also there in the package. So this I believe is a freebie, and it's basically a sticker to measure your kid's height. And now for installing the gate, first we'll push these bolts in. So there are two on the left hand side and two need to go on the right hand side of this gate. And then after inserting the bolts, you'll basically have to twist this back so that the bolt gets extended, and then there's a force applied on the surface on which you're mounting this, and basically that will keep this gate in place. So let's do it for the left hand side first, and then we'll do the same for the other side. And now we'll do the same for the other side as well. So I've tightened all of the four bolts using my hands, and now comes the part of securing it further using this key. So you basically need to place it in here, and then you can tighten the gate further. So I'll do that for all the four bolts that we have here, and then once that is done, we can take this thing off. Alright, so now the gate is finally installed in this passage right here, and it's time for a little demo. So the first thing that we can see here is the locking mechanism. So to open this gate, you basically need to push this latch back, and then you can lift the gate and either pull it towards you or you can push it in the other direction as well. So it opens in both the directions, and for locking this, so you can basically release the gate and it will get automatically locked. And apart from this, there's one more feature. So in case if you want to keep the gate open itself, then you can push it all the way back and then it stays the way it is. So apart from the locking mechanism that we have on top here, there's an additional latching thing that happens at the bottom. So if you notice, this part gets locked in here. So this basically acts like a dual lock or a dual safety thing. And this thing is easy for us to operate. I mean, it's easy for us to open it, but kids won't be able to understand or figure this out. And basically they won't be able to open the gate. So that's it for this one, guys. If you have any questions about this product, then you can add them in the comment section below and I'll answer them as soon as possible. So thank you for watching this video and do subscribe to my channel.